God loves us so much, but because he is perfect in every way, and we are not, we could never be close to him. All the wrong things we have ever done stops us from really knowing him. God's desire to have friendship with every man, woman, and child was so strong he decided to do something about it. God knew that the only way that people could be close to him would be if they were clean on the inside, washed from all the bad things they have ever done. This could only be done if someone perfect could take the punishment. Now, God has a son called Jesus. God loves his son a lot. Jesus has never done anything wrong. He is perfect like God. God knew that Jesus was the only one that could pay for our punishment and save us from forever being separated from him. He also knew that to take our place would mean Jesus would have to suffer from all the things we have done wrong, so we don't have to. God loved his son so much, he didn't want him to suffer, but he loved us so much, he decided to put his plan in action to save the world. Just think about this plan for a little while. Oh, how God loved his son, but he loved us too. The Bible says, for God loved the world so much that he gave his only son so that everyone who believes on him may not die but have eternal life. What a wonderful God we have. The next part of the story will tell you how this exciting plan worked.
Here's your son, and it's brown.
I think he's poor and she doesn't have a big house.
She was kind.
She was young and kind.
She accepted what was given to her. She's really kind. Many years ago, there lived a young girl called Mary. She was born in a village called Nazareth, which was tucked away in the hills of Galilee. Mary was very happy. She was engaged to be married to a carpenter called Joseph, who also lived in the village. They loved each other very much.
The angel came down to her and said that she would have a baby son of God and to name him her Jesus. And then another angel visited Joseph to tell him not to break up with Mary, because he was going to break up with her.
The angel was very bright.
Shocked.
She put up her hand in front of the face like that because there's a very bright eye.
The angel looks like she's small and she's got wings on her back and she can fly and she sings a very nice song.
The angel was called Gabriel, and Angel Gabriel, without all the angels, he was the top angel without all the angels, and God sended Gabriel up from heaven to tell the good news.
Don't say you're going to have Jesus.
Yeah.
It was because she felt like it was Jesus' angel, but it was his angel in for God.
In the beginning, she was pretty scared, but the angel said not to be scared, and she would have
a son of God to, after she married Joseph.
A white dress. With like a gold ring above the head.
Now, Joseph the carpenter was an honest and godly man. On hearing that his bride-to-be, Mary, was expecting a baby, he became very sad. "I'm not the father of this child, therefore I cannot marry her," he thought. He decided to end their engagement, but one night he had a strange dream. "Do not break up with Mary. She has done nothing wrong. The child she is carrying is the Son of God. You will name the baby Jesus. He will grow up to save the world from its sins." When Joseph woke up, he thought about the dream. He realized that it wasn't just a dream, but a message from God, and that God's son, Jesus, would have an earthly father to care for him, and that was Joseph's job. With a happy heart, he began to make preparations to marry Mary as soon as possible.
Mary had to go on a donkey because the baby was very heavy, and Jesus had to guide the way.
It took days and nights.
17 miles.
75 miles.
Could have been about 12 hours or something like that.
Think about bedtime.
75 miles.
72 miles. I don't know.
And it was hard for Mary to go there because it was only a few days until she had a baby born. So she just had to go because that's what the Prime Minister said, so they can get loads of collectors.
Horrible.
You might get pins and needles in your feet, because I get them when I sit too long.
The desert? I think it was in the desert, because the deserts are quite hot and sunny, and you don't get water in places like Tesco's and Asda's and stuff and TVs.
They asked people if they had any rooms, but they were all sold out.
They knocked on every door, seeing if they could stay, but loads of people said no. And then they went to one house, and then they stayed in the stable.
To find the bed.
They went to the innkeeper and said, "Have you got any spare rooms?" And she said, "No, but you can't. I could fit you into the stable, but it's a bit smelly."
I think the barn was like all damp and dark, because it might have had all hay on the floor from what the horses and cows and chickens have been eating.
Cold. Dusty,
old,
and
miserable.
And the cow was surrounding them.
They would have been like bulls and rabbits and like rhinos or something like that.
Had loads of animals and didn't smell very pleasant.
And it had lots of hay in it and they weren't very comfortable.
Jesus was surrounded by cows.
Yeah. You think Mary wanted to stay in the stable? No.
No.
Because it was like animals.
And we didn't have no food.
And it was really loud.
He was in it and
cows and sheep and pigs, I don't know.
Yeah, and
I think it would
might
have been
messy
smelly
in it.
Smelly.
Yeah, messy and smelly and
smelly.
I think it was really noisy.
Yeah, with all the animals going woo.
Yay. Yay. And the seat was like
moo. And they had the baby in there, and then Mia was feeling like nervous because she was a bit nervous having the baby in the stable.
And they didn't have like a baby blanket or anything.
So Mary wrapped him up in something.
They put him in a cradle with some hay in to keep him warm. Because he didn't have no cloth or blanket. So she wrapped him up in cloth and put him in the cradle with some hay on.
That night on the hay in the barn, God's son was born. Baby Jesus, the saviour of all men, women and children, was born in a barn. God must have loved us a lot, to send his only son to be born in a barn. Instead of having doctors and nurses around him, baby Jesus was surrounded by cows.
An angel came to them and they were afraid, but the angel said, please don't be afraid. And they told them that their saviour of the world was born, and they took a little lamb with them as a little present for him.
The angel fly down and the shepherds found out by the angels.
The angel. What came down, and then loads more came down singing.
They were singing praises to God, and they were so happy.
And then the shepherds knelt down and prayed to God to help Jesus celebrate Jesus.
They followed the bright star.
The star led them to where Jesus was.
They bought them the three gifts.
And three kings went to see him.
They gave some gold,
myrrh and frankincense.
Myrrh and gold and...
And clothes. They gave Frankenstein's myrrh. I can't remember what they gave.
Frankenstein myrrh
and Jesus wanted to die for us on a cross to save us.
Because God needed someone to save the world.
He had to die on the cross to save our lives.
He was born to forgive all mankind's sin.
To look after the whole world.
To die in the press, our sins will go to him and he'll save the world.
Why Christmas was invented.
It's Jesus' birthday on Christmas.
Jesus was born on the very first Christmas, so that's why we still celebrate Christmas, and it's a really special day.